हेलो, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस द कैरेक्टर ऑफ क्रिस्टोफर मैहोन इन द प्ले बॉय ऑफ द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड. एज यू नो वेरी वेल दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द डिटेल्ड समरी और द क्रिटिकल समरी ऑफ दिस प्ले written by J.M. Synch. Now, we are going to discuss the most important character, or we can say the hero of this play, that is Christopher Mahon. Although, in the detailed story or summary of this play, we have understood very well about Christopher Mahon. What kind of man he is. Let us see. The playboy of the Western world centers around the character and personality of Christopher Mahon. So he is the hero of this play. He is the chief character of this play. The whole story has been woven around Christopher Mahon. And this whole play runs in the course of just 24 hours. The whole period, that is, we have here the unity of time in this play. And in this brief period, Christie's character undergoes a transformation. So here the word transformation, so far the character of Christie is concerned, is very important. Because what we see in the beginning, what kind of Christie is, what kind of man he is, and how he achieves the appreciation, the praises. But in the end we see how he transforms himself. That is, he returns back to his village. How he changes himself, that is very much important in this play. So far the character of Christie is concerned. And this transformation is in fact the theme of or this play. Certain incidents take place in the play which brings about a change in Christie's personality. Whether such transformation is really possible or not is a matter of opinion, because some critics discuss that such transformation cannot take place. It's not possible. How can a man who was so rude, who was so just like criminal, and who tried many times to kill his own father, now transforms himself, now changes, and he also leaves that place where he was so appreciated, he was so praised. Even Pazin, the girl, was in his love, and even then he became unsympathetic, he became rude, he became otherwise, that he even left his beloved. So this kind of transformation cannot be possible, some critics say, but it's possible. So one may say that the development that takes place in Christie's character is convincing, or one may argue that the author is extravagant. So it's not possible. Some may say that it's not possible. The author, the writer, the playwright is just exaggerating the character of Christie. Now let us see some points about Christie's character. So at first we see the arrival at the public house. So first of all, we hear about Christy from Sean. Sean is another character at the public house we have seen, who was also engaged in affairs with Pazin and wanted to marry her. So he tells Pazin that he had heard a strange man groaning in the ditch, nearby the ditch. And then we see that this young fellow, that is Christy, enters Michael James' public house. Public house name is Shabin. Shabin is the name of that public house, that pub house. And he's looking very strange and frightened and dirty. So first of all, we see Christy as strange, frightened, and dirty looking. He also seems to be tired, very much tired, because he has traveled long distance on foot. Everybody looks at him very strangely, and he is feeling very miserable. This is that for the first time we meet with Christy at the public house. Then we come to know about Christy's crime, why he has come on that place and why he left his own village and why he's so tired and why he's so looking dirty and why he's so worried. So we come to know that Christy has committed a crime. And what was that crime? You know very well that it was the crime of murdering of his own father. As he has described, as he has said, we come to know about this crime from his own words. So he tells that he is surely in danger of being arrested. So he says that yes, really, he is in danger that the police may arrest him because he has committed a crime. And his crime is of much more serious crime. The nature of his crime, he says that much more serious. So then the public, then the Pazin, then the other people who are there at the pub, they asked him ki what kind of the crime he has done, whether he has molested some woman or whether he has assaulted some balibs or having minted some spurious coins, that is the farji note chapne ka koi kaam kiya hai aur ya usne koi bigamy yani do istriyan rakhne wala kaam kiya hai. To wo sab kehta hai ki no, he has not done, he has never tried like these things. That is, he has never molested any woman, nor assaulted balibs, or having minted spurious coins, or having committed bigamy. But during this conversation, eventually he says that he had killed his father, hitting a blow with a spear. That is the crime that he has done. So hearing these words from Christy, everyone at the public house begins to think him a hero. So he becomes a hero in the eyes of Pazin and others. Because he admitted the truth only after he was cornered by Pazin. So he tells Pazin that he has really committed a crime of murdering his father. But as we know that hearing all these things, all the people there, including Pazin, they were surprised. And he became appreciation in the eyes and in the heart of those people. Even Michael, Jimmy, Philly, Pazin, they all look very impressed by his action that he has killed his own father. They think him a hero, that he has performed a brave deed. Pazin, in spite of Sean's oppose, because Sean was opposing, Sean was not liking all these things. He knew very well that Christy is attracted towards Pazin and Pazin is also interested in Christy. So he says that, oh, he is speaking a lie. We cannot believe that he has really killed his father. Or therefore, Pazin and Michael James, who wanted to give an employment, a job or work at the public house, Sean opposes. Pazin says that she will feel very safe with him if he is appointed there, because many times his father is away at nights, Therefore, if Christie is there with her, at the night there will be no danger at all. And that's why we see that Christie is kept or is given the appointment at the public house. Christie also thanks God for good luck that has fallen upon him due to two fine women, Basine and Widow Queen, because both of them were attracted towards him, Basine as well as Widow Queen, and they were in favor of Christie. So Christie thanks God, and each one of them wants him for herself. That was also the matter. Widow Queen also wanted to marry him. Basine was also interested in Christie, and she fell in love with him. So it seems, Christie, that this murder of his father has made him a hero in the eyes of the people there. So the point is here that Christie thinks that if he had not murdered his father, he would not have got such appreciation and praises from here, and such position, such prestige, such image, such confidence. So he thinks that his committing the murder of his father has become a fortune for him, and that has made him a hero in the eyes of those people. Now Christie, a non-entity in his own village, he tells himself that no one knew him before this murder, because at his own village he was not popular. His father did not regard him good, and he was not a kind of man. He was not a kind of good man. He used to waste his time. He spent his time waking, eating, sleeping, and just like a simple poor favolo, with no man giving him heed. No girl would love him. No girl were attracted towards him. But he thinks that after murdering his father, and when he has come at this new place, he has got everything. So he can never imagine. So when Basine says that she had thought that he had been living in his village like a king, his reply shows that he was merely a poor, overworked and neglected. So Basine and others thought that he might be living just like a king at his own village. But he clears this. No, he was not like a king there. He was merely poor, overworked, always working too much, and neglected by everyone. So he says in these words, I quote these words that were spoken by Christie to Basine, ki the like of a king is it? And I, after toiling, moiling, digging, dodging from the dawn till dusk, with never a sight of joy or sport. God forgive me, and I nearly got 6 months for going with a dung fork and stabbing a fish. These were the words spoken by Christie when asked by Basine, or said by Basine, that he might have been living a life of king at his own village. So he says, no, not at all that. He was just like a poor fellow. Nobody looked at him. He also says that he endured all that ill treatment by his bad-tempered father. That whatever the bad temperament, whatever the bad treatment, ill treatment that he got at his own village was due to his bad-tempered father. So in short, he says that his life in his native village was that of a man for whom nobody cared at all. And his father is responsible for all those things. And that's why he says that he has murdered his father. Then we see old Mahon's contemptuous portrayal of Christie's character. We know how his own father describes about Christie when he first appears at this public house and meets with the other people. He tells everyone that Christie is a liar on walls, a talker of folly, a man who stretched himself to the sun, that always in lethargicity, lying and basking always in the sun. He also says that Christie was incapable of doing any useful work at all on the farm. So he also tells them that Christy is not at all a good boy, good young man, and he's dirty one. He is not capable of doing any useful work, and he is idle young man, that is murk, polish, bekar. और जो कुछ उसने किया वो ये था कि all that he did was to fool over little birds or make faces at himself in the mirror. कि ये क्या करता है, ये अपने दर्पण में जो है कि अपना चेहरा बनाता रहता है और कुछ भी काम नहीं करता था, कोई काम का नहीं है. इस प्रकार से उसका फादर वहाँ पे उसके बारे में मेंशन करता है. और वो ये भी कहता है कि there was no question of his son running after the girls because he was terribly shy. और जहाँ तक लड़कियों की बात है कि भाई वो लड़कियों के पीछे भागता था, कि वो कहता है उसका फादर कि ये भी कोई मतलब ही नहीं है, क्योंकि वो इतना शाई है, इतना डरपोक है कि वो पीछे क्या भागना, वो उनसे बहुत ज़्यादा डरता था. He always avoided the girls. So these things about Christie's character we get from his own father. How his father describes Christie and thinks about his own son. So this is very important so far. We discuss the character of Christie. And he says that he would hide himself behind the shrubs whenever the girls would come towards him. The women of the village used to poke fun at him and referred him as the loony of Mahons, that is the mad son of Mahon. So, he cannot be the lover of the women. Even the women used to make fun of him and they would call him the loony of Mahons, that is the mad son of Mahon. So, these are the descriptions that are given by his father. Nor Christie was good at smoking and drinking. He also tells that Christie is not at all good at smoking and drinking. तो किसी भी क्षेत्र में वो कहना चाहता है कि Christie कुछ भी नहीं है, सबसे बेकार है, न ड्रिंकिंग में, न स्मोकिंग में, न लड़कियों में, कोई वुमन उसकी प्रेज नहीं करती है, न वो कोई काम करता है, न कोई काम करने के योग्य है. So all the negative points of Christie's characters were described by his own father and told to all the people who were there at that shabeen at the public house. He had a queer rotten stomach, he has also said. He also describes him as a small, low fellow, dark and dirty, an ugly young blackguard. In this way, old Mahon, his father, described young Christie. These were the words. I have here highlighted these words. These are the original words that were spoken in the play by the characters. So, we have to analytical so far discussing the character of Christie. I have described only the half part of this question or this topic that is about the Christie's character. The half part, the later or the second part of his character, we will discuss in the next video or next hour lecture. So, what we have seen here, that what kind of man Christie was in the very beginning, where we meet and what he has done and how he is appreciated and made hero at the shabeen, and what his own father thinks about him and understands about him. That is the important point here, is that Christie creates a false story at Shabeen, that is the murdering of his own father, and his position becomes very uneasy and very uncomfortable when his father, that is old Mahon, appears at the shabeen, at the public house, and he discloses the things, the reality about his own son. He says that this is my son, but we know that the characters, the people who are there, they don't believe in old Mahon's words. And we also see how Widow Queen helps Christie to run away his father from there. It is old Queen who makes old Mahon go away from that place. So in this way, she helps Christie. And we know why she helps Christie, that is, she wants to marry him. So these are some of the points that we have discussed regarding the character of Christie. The other points regarding his character we will discuss in our next video. So till then, thank you very much, dear friends. See you.